Was still bent since he lost the cars.
Tjena grabbar, jag tycker om såna här slags spel. Jag tycker du gör det så bra. Tack så mycket, Stefan. Och hej.
You know how to get into one of these, Tommy?
Elbow goes through, reach inside, easy.
And in the afternoon, to
fix the window back up. Watch. And learn.
You're a regular magician, Ralphie.
Och V to pick a card lock. Varför kan man inte bara hålla in E? För det är ändå den knappen för att ta sig in.
Okej, it's car. You got it.
Fan, i tvåan har man ju värsta minigamet för att bryta sin egen bil. All right, let's bolt.
First we got Al. He runs a bakery on Longman Street.
Oi,
Al's late again.
Seems so. That's too bad.
Super science stories. Okej. Okay. Jag såg på att det kommer fram på minimappen när det är en collectible. Vi får hålla utkik där. Vibing music. Det känns typ som att alltså, svängarna är så tröga. Eller lite tröga, men typ det är så mycket vikt. Så det känns typ som att bilen ska välta när man svänger. Sen en fråga. Du får välja att enas äta Delicatoboll eller Double Dime resten av livet. Vilken blir det? Jag ska göra dig besviken och säga Delicatoboll alla dagar i veckan. Jag är inte ett superfan av Dime. Just för att det är så... Det är så här, fucka med tänderna för mig. Det är typ för hårt. Så det är ett ganska enkelt val för mig faktiskt. Och Delicatoboll är också... Otroligt gott. Vad hade du valt då? Skulle nog också välja bollen faktiskt, även om det är mina två bästa. Bollen är mer mat. Sant. Jag tror att man står sig lite bättre på smör och kakao. Vad fan det är. Kolla vad duktig jag är som nästan inte kör på trottoaren när jag svänger.
Okej, this is it.
Oops.
Watch what we do today, Tom. When it goes smooth, it's a breeze. When they put up a fight, sometimes you gotta think on your feet.
Sure.
Just follow my lead.
Ska jag följa mig in? Enter bakery, yes. Ooh, får jag döda någon?
Sam, Polly, how are you?
We're good. How's little Julia?
Ha. Not so little now. She's turning into a pain in the ass, just like her grandma.
That's good to hear, Al. Real good. Now, you got any trouble around?
Dear Mr. Bertorelli, this letter is a notification that you are in default of your obligation to make payments on your agreed loan. This amount has been overdue since July 15th, 1930. When the night I had him, you have ignored request to pay this debt. Unless the full amount is received within 2 weeks, I will have no choice but to instruct this bank to begin the foreclosure process on your home and business. Please act accordingly. Christopher Marcino, manager, Grand Imperial Bank. Ouch.
Here. Any
context.
Causing problems?
No, no. Nothing like that.
Good. So you got the money?
I got it waiting in the back room.
Tommy will get it. You stay here where we can see you.
It's been real slow this month, Sam. I was worried I wouldn't have enough.
Al, I know you'd never hold out on us, but it's good you worry. I mean, how can we protect you and little Julia without paying?
You gonna take all day, Tommy? We got places we need to be.
I hate the cigarette card, bro.
Where's the money?
Ron, fetch up.
Voi ci succhiate il sangue.
It's on the table, brown envelope.
Via di qui.
Grazie.
Lasciateci in pace.
Oh, okay. Extremely nice lady. Yes.
I got it. We'll see you next month, Al. Let us know if you need anything. Anything at all.
Sure will, Sam. Sure will.
I could use that envelope of money. Ooh, cakes. Okay, vilken av de här ser godast ut då?
It was a real pleasure meeting you.
Jordgubbstårtan eller chokladtårtan? Hmm. Why not both? Let's
okay,
jet.
Next up we got old Eugene's place. Chinese store up on Tallow.
He's not dead yet?
Almost. Heard his nephew's taking over.
Guy used to run this next place, Tom. His name's not Eugene. Guy's a Chinaman. But it sounds like Eugene. Well, that's what we called him.
Polly slammed his head into the counter back in, what, 27, I think?
Yeah, it was hilarious. After that, no problems at all.
If you look, you can still see the blood. Poor old bastard couldn't scrub it out.
And there's a dude you've sort on. Hmm? So smart.
We keep some of these guys on our books to remind the Chinatown gangs they're in our city, not theirs. But we don't know Eugene's nephew, so he might need reminding too.
Guaranteed to be of the highest quality and best price locally. For fixtures, paints, lumber, and more, visit Edmunds Tools, home of the Edmunds Price Guarantee. Scheduled music programs and regular news bulletins brought to you by Lost Heaven Radio.
Ah, jolly good. Jolly good, sir. Last Heaven Radio.
In need of refreshment?
Så kan jobba nu. Han finns inte detsamma. Jag bara hoppas... Hoppas du har en fin dag på jobbet. Vad konstigt det där kändes i spelet. Det lät som att folk började skjuta mot mig. Så. Undrar hur lagligt man egentligen behöver köra. Jag tror att så länge man inte krockar och inte kör över speedmetern så tror jag att...
Hey Ralphie, I said. Tom sure can drive. No working after hours, cleaning up after
being snuten sa ingenting,
Sam.
I alla fall så det kanske inte ens...
No chance of that, huh? This is it. I'll cover this one, Sam.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure.
He's doing the store on his own?
Yeah, when Polly's built up a little steam, he needs to let it out on his own. Just gotta let him get on with it. It's his way. You can hear it in his voice. Gotta let him lone wolf from time to time. Keeps him happy. Yeah, Eugene's nephew ain't having much fun right now. When he's going, Polly don't stop. Once we were putting a squeeze on this tailor over in Holbrook, the guy ended up in a wheelchair.
Man, Polly sounds like a swell guy. Very cool. Very cool guy.
Here he comes.
He's a fast worker.
Drive before the cops show, Tom. Next stop's Bill at the motel. Eugene's nephew's guy's money is ours next week, with some extra besides.
He doing okay?
He's okay.
How's the shop counter?
Yeah, that's seen some more blood.
How much blood?
And nothing he can't scrub out. Once he's back on his feet.
You wanna come out with us again, Tom? Get to hear even more about Chinese nephew guys scrubbing their own blood out of shop counters.
Yeah, seems like it's not too hard.
Not hard. Kind of not hard.
I don't know. Comes natural to you guys. Don't see why it can't come natural to me.
So anyone could do this. Me and Polly, we've been working these streets for years. You come in and you think you know it all.
I'm not saying that, Sam.
You've been a day on the job, pal. You haven't seen what we do. You haven't seen how we do it. Sam, I think you're...
Vi åker ut på landet nu.
No, Polly. This punk thinks he can walk in here like a big shot. I put greasers like him in the ground.
I think you gotta say you're sorry, Tom.
Sorry, huh? Well, I'd say sorry if I couldn't see the bullshit smile you're trying to hide.
You got him, though, Sam! You got him!
Va? I can smell the crap
in your pants from here.
Nah, you didn't get me.
When little Tony first came out with us, I had him on his knees before he knew I was yanking his chain.
Yeah, you did better than him anyways.
Lite trögstartat det här spelet faktiskt. Har inte hänt så mycket än.
Jesus, kört bil.
Oh, vackert.
You hate it most places. Yeah, but out here it's worse.
How come there's a place so far out of town on our books?
Out of town's the safest place for deals. Safest place for card games. The safest place for most of the things we do. We're expecting a big bag of money today. The guy owes. If it ain't big, the boss will be pissed.
Yeah, this place is a real earner. Oftentimes, the places that get you the most dough are the ones most people don't look at twice.
Just recently, the motel's had a new lease of life.
Last stop before Lost Heaven for rum coming up from Cuba.
They drive it this far.
Sure they do. And that's how we can sell it so expensive.
Bill's motel has gotten to be the place where crates get exchanged. Salieri protects it, but he lets the other families use it too.
Even Morello?
To keep the peace? Sure.
Plus, it's far enough away that no one cares.
So long as everyone's making money, no one's gonna rock the boat. Drive safe, Tom.
Whoops. Det var en sten där. Var är vi ens? Oh. The airport.
It's the side of streets and sidewalks.
You not one for the great outdoors, Polly?
He's not one for anything. Indoors, outdoors, in the city, out of the city.
I hate it out here. Like when we sit in the field doing some booze handover or something. It's always knee deep in shit, and most times it's dark and cold as hell.
That's why it's good we got you now, Tom. You can do all the jobs that Polly hates.
But happy to oblige.
Det är lite som att köra i slow motion på den här bilen. Den är väldigt tung. Kan man byta radio? VLH. Okej. Okay. Ah. Man kunde byta radiokanal. Mysigt.
Okay, there it is.
Finally! Wait for us here, Tom. We'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
Jag känner igen den här gula bilen. Something's gonna go down.
Tell Salieri from here on out this place is ours. Capisce? And don't come back, or you'll end up in worse shape than your friends.
Get Sam. They're trying to get information out of
him. I gotta get you to a doctor.
I can wait. Get Sam out of there.
Okay, just hang on.
It's shooting time. Okay.
Next time I'll tell him. I'll tell him I had enough of this bullshit.
What? Såg han mig?
Han... Whoa.
Death rattles. Kan jag flytta kroppen?
Maybe I should take her dancing or something. Something she likes.
Det är inte mycket bättre, men det är lite bättre. Jag hatar att han har så ryckningar där inne. Eller där uppe.
Ooh.
Mycket skott har jag. Okej. Okay. Mm. Oj. Det här går inte bra. Okej. Okay. What? Fuck it. Nu kör vi. Action. Adam. Kom då, stånga med.
Get up their side. Right there.
Du. Nice. Så vi tar ett litet varv här uppe. Wow. Här då. Varför inte ha en uppstoppad räv typ mitt på... Kan man loota kroppar? Pick up baseball bat. Pick up body. Nej. Oh, jag ser ammo. Tyckte jag hörde saker. Finns det något loot? Nu är det spinnande.
Gonna take you out.
Oh.
You're in my sight.
Vad är det här? Ouch. Oj. Okej. Det där såg konstigt ut. Buggy.
Ooh.
Why hello? Nej, den här jag får använda. Page down. Varför skulle jag köra den? Kan jag... vill ha mer ammo till min shotgun. Först ska jag kolla här. Bring prosperity. Elect Roberto Gilotti for City Council 1930. A trusted figure in Lost Heaven. Owner of boat yards and industry. Employer 2000s. Friend of the city. Dutiful father and husband. All right.
Gotcha now.
Nice. Ouch. Det här är jag gillar inte det där. Det där är något skumt. Nu måste jag kolla här. Display. Ah, det är för att jag har field of viewen. Vad är standard? Vad är default? Vänta, eller är det screen borders kanske?
You're dying today.
Am I? You dead. Oh. Såg någonting på minimappen. Det finns en bok där ute. I need to get it. Haha. Time detective. Okej, okay, och jag kan swap. Vill jag testa? Varför inte? Finns det något annat gett här? Pick up body. Någon här bakom. Var det en service revolver jag hade här ute? Som jag swappade. Pocket revolver. Mm. Där är han. Okej.
Okay. Sam. Oh, they really went to work on you, buddy. Christ. Come on. You'd be all right. You're tough as nails.
What the fuck?
Oh, shit. He's got the money, Tom. Oh, catch the bastard.
Where is Sam?
He's okay. Inside.
Then go get the money.
Let's do this. Man har inte världens... Aha. Där. Okej. Okej, jag får inte sikta. Det är lite knasigt. Försöker jag typ paja motorn, eller? Bra. Det var jättedåligt. Nej. Jag ska bara köra igenom den här kyrkogården lite fort. Nej. Alltså varför den här röda markören är så jävla out of place. Jag förstår inte riktigt varför. Nej. Kör. Inte har mycket HP kvar heller. Nu då. Det ska komma fram så här. Press F to ram other vehicles. Ja.
Saw the cost, what it meant to be on the inside. I should have took off there and then, but I couldn't go back to being a nobody.
Couldn't go back to being a nobody. Snabbt rört maffia livet. All right.
So that's how a regular palooka goes from cabbie to mob enforcer overnight, is it? Just dumb luck.
Didn't feel that way at the time. Me parking on that particular street, taking a break just when Paulie and Sam are coming around the corner, what are the odds? I felt like, I don't know, like someone was watching out for us.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, pal, but it's a lucky break all the same. I mean, one day you're busting your back, doing an honest day's work in a city that's been trying to scrape you off its heels since the day you stepped off the boat, and the next you're stuffing your pockets full of Salieri's dirty money and lording it over the rest of us.
Yeah, it wasn't like that. Back then, Salieri didn't have the run of the city. For every buck Salieri made, Don Morello would turn 10. He paid off cops, politicians, judges, and anyone he couldn't buy, he scared into looking the other way.
He did seem to have the city jumping in its own shadow, I'll give you that.
You hear anything about Joey Crackers?
Yeah, got his name in the Morello file, sure. Boxer, right?
Yeah. That's the guy. Way I hear it, Joey was just driving to the gym one morning. Probably daydreaming about winning a belt or something.
God damn it! Moron! You drive with your goddamn eyes closed! Look at this! Jesus, Mary. Joseph, Dom. Tom Morello, I didn't know it was you.
Do you know anybody else driving a rare import in this part of town, Joey?
No. Well, then, I'm sorry, I was driving real slow.
You're saying this is my fault?
No, sir. I ain't never been in no accident.
Well, repairs are gonna be expensive.
Oh, you're not gonna need that, sir. The tires are just fine. It's, grill's a little bent up is all. I mean, I got a cousin, I got...
Awkward.
Someone spun you a tail, pal. You got an informant right there, says Morello made a mint every time Crackers went to the mat.
That's true, too. And still, Morello left that poor sap dead in the street, head all caved in.
That don't square.
Well, maybe the Don knew Joey's career was on the downhill. Well, maybe he was trying to scare some other guy into paying up. Who knows? Don Salieri chalked it up to Morello not being able to think straight when he was mad.
You have any more run-ins with Morello's crew back then?
Not at first. For a couple of years after I joined up, things were quiet. We got into a few dust-ups with guys trying to muscle in, but elsewise it was just the usual routine. We were running booze, offering protection, me and the boys doing rounds to collect, small time. But I ain't gonna lie. Most days, we was also having a bit of fun.
Ooh, we about to have some fun, eh? Don Morello verkar också vara en skön kille.
Tommy, thanks for getting down here so quickly.
Yeah, sure thing, boss. What do you need?
You know, there's a race coming up.
Oh, yeah. Paulie and Sam have some money on the local.
Mikey Dunn.
That's the guy.
He's a good kid, but a bit of a scrapper. Not too smart with his money. A few years ago, Mikey comes to me asking for a loan. He wants to get new tires so he can keep racing junkers out at the quarry. I like fast cars. I figured it'll be a bit of a hobby. Turns out, Mikey's a great investment. The kid can't lose a race if he walks the track. He graduates from the junkers to gouge-jobs, and I start placing a few bets on him here and there. Next thing I know, I've made all my money back and more.
Hey, Sam says he's the guy to beat.
He was. We ran all the competition out of town. But now Ralph says there's a hotshot European entering the race, and he's got a car faster than our boys by a country mile.
How much do we stand to lose?
A truckload. But not just our outfit. A lot of guys from the neighborhood come to me for financial advice. They've all put money down on this kid. It'll be like Black Thursday around here if he loses. Well, for everyone except Morello.
Oh, you think he's from the European?
Oh, I'm certain of it.
You want something to happen to the driver?
Can't find him. Morello's got him holed up somewhere safe. Besides, if he drops out or disappears now, none of our wagers will stand. Everyone will cry foul, say the race is fixed.
What about his car?
That's the ticket, Tommy. Ralph knows a guard at the track. You go down there tonight, you boost the European's car, Bring it to one of our mechanics. I'll make a few adjustments. You bring the car back.
Should be no problem, boss.
Sarah, can I get a drink here?